Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for your grace. Thank you for your mercy and your love. Father, we thank you for this day and the day of your rest. Father, we thank you that you have given us the invitation to come and also be in your rest. Father, we receive our healing. We enter into your rest, O Lord, because that's where we know we will be loved. That's where we know that we will be restored, O Lord. Father, every cells in our body renewed, recharged. And Father, we know that this is the day that you have selected, the day that you have made where we will rejoice. Father, we thank you that we are in great company in our rest. We thank you, Father, for our friends. We also remember our enemies, people that have spoken ill of us. Father, we just pray that you will forgive them, because we have forgiven them. Father, we thank you for those that are listening through streaming this morning. In this busy time, O Lord, that they have put away this time to come and rest. And while we are resting, we want to discuss about you, O Lord. And most importantly, about who we are and our task that you have nominated for us. Father, we thank you this morning for your word that we will share, that you are going to put it into the depth of our heart, and your Ruach HaKodesh will nurture it so that in time of our need it'll come up for us to partake of that word for the healing of our body, for the healing of our mind, and for our spirit. Father, we give you all praise and honor. And for those that I need today, O Lord, that they will be met through your grace and through your mercy. Hallelujah. Thank you for your Ahava today. Thank you for your Chesed. Thank you for your Chen. The grace of God. Hallelujah. Father, we just give you praise and give you honor. In Yeshua's mighty name we pray, and everybody says, Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord this morning. We are blessed for this beautiful day. Again, we are in Sydney. We try to contact the facility people, and we had no response, and we've decided we will have our service from Tyrell Street, here in 9 Tyrell Street, Rockville. Firstly, I want to welcome everybody that is watching. Lotoka, Central Messianic, Fiji, we've got Emmanuel and Hallelujah, and big shalom to those that are also watching from Suva, Save, Taunga, Gabriela, and all those that are listening. I may not mention your name today. Hallelujah. We just pray that God is going to really touch us, continue to build us in a very important year today. Hallelujah. Today also it's exciting for Central Messianic, because we're also going to declare the theme of the church or the ministry for this 2016. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Without further ado, I just want to read to us our title of our message this morning. It is in Hebrew, Serutzkem. Serutzkem. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Is a word that is taken from Serut, And it is very important for us to know what it means, hallelujah. So, and our text is taken from 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 1 and 2. Sorry, there's no one actually working the thing. We haven't put it into the slideshow today. There's no one working the machine. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 1. I'm just going to read from here. I'm sorry about that. Therefore, seeing we have this ministry, as we have received mercy, we faint not, but have renounced the hidden things of dishonesty, not walking in craftiness, nor handling the word of God deceitfully, but by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. Now, Paul, speaking to the Corinthians, and it's very important that we understand, because today it's about ministry. Serotkem is actually translated in English, your ministry. Your ministry. So what had happened is ministry is always, there's always a misconception regarding our ministry. And I believe there's not enough said about ministry. Hallelujah. Suffice to mention, we find our ministry only after we find our relationship with God. See, most of us receive Yeshua as our Lord and our Savior. And when we receive Yeshua, and that's when we find our ministry. It's important I stress that, because some people with that ministry, they forget about their relationship with God. The most important thing in our lives, in ministry, is our relationship with God needs to be spot on. That has to be first all the time. Hallelujah. That has to be first all the time. So, in ministry, we must have our relationship. I've seen a lot of people, I'm talking about preacher, I'm talking about pastors, ordained minister, that have fallen because they've brought their ministry in front and they've left their relationship second. Now it's the other way around. We, and Paul is saying here that, therefore, seeing we have this ministry as we have received mercy. So you received mercy because of your relationship with God. That need not change. You must maintain your relationship with God. And ministry needs to come second to that. Hallelujah. I remember growing up and I am seeing a lot of children, pastors, their children. They are involved in other things that are not godly. You know why? Because they've forgotten also one important thing. Because if you have your relationship with God, your relationship with your family and your neighbors needs to be also the next one. So where does that put ministry? That put ministry number three. So first, it is your relationship with God, relationship with your family, and then relationship, and then your ministry. It needs to have this order, in exactly that order. A lot of people have fallen out of the ministry. We're going to study the word in the ministry here. Hallelujah. If you can just excuse me a bit, I don't think anybody's taken my hint. I'm just going to change it to, because I want you to have a look at this. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So if we can go back and see, that is the word there, serutkem. Serutkem, and your ministry. It means your ministry. We look at our text, and it's in 2 Corinthians. Therefore, seeing we have this ministry, as we have received mercy, we faint not, but have renounced the hidden things of dishonesty, not walking in craftiness, nor handling the word of God deceitfully, but by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. As I've already mentioned to you, that ministry needs to come third. Hallelujah. A lot of people have fallen. Their family have, children have done other things. Hallelujah. Because people have put their ministry first, and their relationship and family after. Hallelujah. Today is very important to understand what Paul is saying. Therefore, seeing we have this ministry, as we have received mercy, we faint not. That means a lot of people give up. A lot of people give up because they've put ministry first. We need to have our relationship with God first all the time, and our family. It needs to be in that order, my friend. Hallelujah. There are some young people there that want to be used to God. I'm thankful for that desire. But remember, when you come to ministry, your relationship with God is very important. Hallelujah. Because if you don't, pride will come. Because when you have your ministry, you're going to be hearing a lot of word from other people saying good things about you. Hallelujah. You must remember, because if you don't put the relationship of God first, you are going to think that you are something. And next thing, pride will come. That's why we need to have our relationship first before anything else. Hallelujah. As I've already said, there's always a misconception. Hallelujah. So again, in the order, again, if we can see that importance, a relationship with God, relationship with your family and your neighbors, these are all scriptural. Hallelujah. We'll look at the scripture later. And number three is your ministry. Hallelujah. So it is very much sarutkem. Your ministry, sarutkem. Sometimes we find pastor spends much time in ministry and neglect the family and the neighbor. It's very, very important. Very simple as well. Hallelujah. But first, let's have a look at this word ministry. The Hebrew word sarat. Now you notice, for you Hebrew student, that sarutkem is an inflection of this word sarat. So it means to attend. As a menial worshiper. Okay? Menial means unskilled. So, for this, we can deduce that the perception of a ministry we usually have as only the pastor and deacons have a ministry is incorrect. Hallelujah. So, let me share this with you, because we think that only the pastors and the deacons have the ministry. I want us, Central Messianic One New Man today, that idea needs to go out the window. Because this word, saret, means menial or worshiper. Menial means unskilled. So what is important is, it's not because of your skill, it's because of your availability. Ministry is about availing yourself. It's got nothing to do about your talent. It's about availing yourself. So it says here, sarat, to attend as a menial or worshiper. Later on, we'll find another word that's translated servant in the Bible. And you will know, and then this word sarat or ministry comes very clear, hallelujah, to us today. So more about this word sarat. There on your screen, you will find sarat used in a generic sense to describe the following. Domestic servant serving a ranking official. So this is the word sarat. A chief assistant to an authority figure. A religious service to the Lord. So now you see that in the first one, domestic servant. So you are serving somebody, a ranking official, somebody in authority. Genesis 39:4, it says in the King James, and Joseph found grace in his sight. And he served Sarat. Hallelujah. So some places in the Bible you see this word serve and servant, they are different. We'll have a look at that later. And he made him overseer over his house, and all that he had he put in his hand. So two things one should desire: find grace in the sight of God and men, and have dominion over a situation. So Joseph found them by serving. Hallelujah. He made himself available. Hallelujah. He makes sure that he brings his A game to that service. It's very important for us as people who are serving in church. Hallelujah. It's not about how good you are, how skilled you are. No, it's about you being available for a job. Remember, you are an assistant. Hallelujah. So we look at that next as a chief assistant to... Hallelujah. So, and that's in, chief assistant to all authority figure. You find that in Exodus chapter 24. And Moses rose up and his minister, Sarat, that's the word used there, Joshua. And Moses went up into the Mount of God. So, notice, Joshua ministered to Moses. While Joshua is witnessing what God is doing, he recognized that there is another authority above Moses. See? When Joshua came to take over the reign as a leader with the Israelites, he knew that he's not an assistant to Moses in his service to Moses. He's actually an assistant to God. What I mean is that God cannot come down and be an assistant to Moses. He needed a human being. He needed someone that's already here to be an assistant. So what you're doing, you are God's hand. Joshua is a God's hand to Moses. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So whatever you're doing, your ministry is not to the person you're, it's not to the pastor. It's not to the deacon. Your ministry is unto God. You are assisting God fulfilling what He wants. So God doesn't use anything else, but He used men. Hallelujah. So you are an assistant as a ministry. You must remember, whatever you're doing in church, if you are preparing electronic things, that's your ministry. And remember, you're not doing it to the pastor. You're not doing it to somebody else. You are there as God's hand doing this, because the work cannot be done if nobody sets up. The work cannot be done if nobody is giving. Hallelujah. I thank God for the people that are giving in Central Messianic. Hallelujah. Why? Because they are the hand of God in the ministry, in their ministry. So whatever you're doing, your perception of ministry, I hope changes today. That you are doing it as an assistant to God, because He's the authority. So Joshua realized earlier on in his life that there is an authority that is much higher than Moses. So when he's performing his duty, he's not performing it to Moses. He's the hand of God helping Moses fulfill what God wanted to do through Moses. See, that's why when we come to church, you bring your ministry to be in line with whatever the pastor has got. Hallelujah. Why? Because God has given a vision to that pastor. He's given a plan to that pastor. And you're going to bring your ministry because you're going to see the plan of God that is given to the pastor. And you are going to be the hand of God in that. If it's giving, oh Lord, this is for you. Because of your call on this man, I'm the hand that's giving here. I am the feet that's going to go and tell people. Because that's the what you're going to, or that's the plan that you have for the man of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I hope we understand what ministry is after this message, because it is very important. Hallelujah. Qualification is actually in Numbers chapter 23, verse 8. And the Lord said unto Moses, take thee Joshua, son of Nun, a man in whom is the Spirit, and lay thy hand upon him. That's a revelation from above. Hallelujah. He said, take thee Joshua, the son of Nun, a man in whom is the Spirit. Remember, he need to be filled with the Spirit. Important that we are filled with the Holy Spirit, with the Ruach HaKodesh. Hallelujah. In your ministry, I said earlier, your relationship with God needs to be spot on, needs to be first and always the first. Hallelujah. And your relationship with people and your family needs to be second. And your ministry comes. Hallelujah. So it's very important for us to understand it. Hallelujah. And that, so God reveals. God reveals and you act upon that. So it's very important for us to understand. Hallelujah. Matthew chapter 16 verse 17. Hallelujah. And Jesus answered and said unto him, blessed art thou, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood had not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. Hallelujah. Who do you say I am? That's the question that brought on this answer from Yeshua. The question he was asking the disciple, who do you say I am? And Peter said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. And he said to Peter, blessed art thou, Simon Bar-Jonah. See, this is where we see in Simon Bar-Jonah. Hallelujah. For flesh and blood has not revealed it unto you. So the word Bar-Jonah is the son of Jonah. So this is where sometimes I say that we know that Yeshua was speaking Aramaic. He wasn't speaking Greek because of this word. The word Bar is son of in Aramaic, which in Hebrew is Ben. Okay, so we know that they were speaking both Hebrew and Aramaic in the early days. Just a little note there for you Hebrew students in understanding what your Bible is saying. Hallelujah. So, chief assistant. Hallelujah. So, okay, chief assistant. Let me introduce you to a word that's also translated in the King James as servant. Moses was the servant of the Lord. Now look at this. Moses, this is in Deuteronomy chapter 34, verse 5. So Moses the servant, and the word used there is not Sarat, it is Abed. Abed of the Lord died there in the land according to the word of the Lord. So you see, here we have two words. One is Sarat and one is Abed. Sarat, we've already discussed, is how you bring yourself to be the hand of God, to be an assistant. Okay, that's who you are. In your ministry, you are an assistant to the authority of God. You're not an assistant to the pastor. You're not an assistant to anybody else. But you are an assistant to what God is planning in the church. But here, Moses, the word said, Abed. Abed. Is the word if we can see the meaning of a bed here means a slave. Moses was not an assistant, he was a slave. Okay? So, Saret means to be an assistant. If God wants the church toilets cleaned, this is an example, he is not coming down to do it. See, God is not going to come down and clean the toilet. Being the high authority needs an assistant who avails herself or himself. So the toilet cleaner, therefore, is not assisting the pastor nor the deacons, but the high authority of God. See, that's an example that I've just brought to you. God is not going to come down to do the menial things. Okay? We do it. We make ourselves available to do that. So why? You are an assistant to him. Hallelujah. You are an assistant to God. Please take that with you, receive it in your heart. In whatever minute you are involved in the ministry, you're not an assistant to the pastor. You're an assistant, not an assistant to whoever is there, but you are an assistant to God. Here Moses is a bed. Hallelujah. Now you and I don't want to go there, because I think a lot of people will start scratching their head, put in Moses' place. Like for example, he is a man that had traveled 40 years with the Israelites. And God brought him and he stood there and he said, see, that's the land that I promised your fathers. But you're not going to make it. This is where you end. Now I would have turned around, man, this is not fair. But God is a slave. He just does what the master says. Can you do that? Oh, give me ministry. 365 days a week, year. Hallelujah. Because Moses is a slave, isn't a bed. When he says a servant. So when you say you're a servant of the Lord, be careful what you say. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because some of us cannot even go through the first trial, let alone the third. Hallelujah. So Moses is an abed. He is a slave. He does what is told. Hallelujah. So you are an assistant. Today I want you to understand that. Hallelujah. So God is not coming down to preach. Hallelujah. So you are his mouthpiece, assisting him, preaching to the lost. I've written something there. So your ministry is to preach. Hallelujah. So if you are a teacher, remember he is looking for an assistant to help him teach. 1 Corinthians 12:28, it says, and God had set some in church, first apostles, secondly prophets, thirdly teachers, after that miracles, then gifts of healing, helps, and governments. So a lot of people help in the governance of the church. So some in church, he said some in church. See, the relationship is there already. People that have a relationship. He doesn't set some in the street, but some in church. Hallelujah. So he's looking for assistance in church. Those that have his mercy, I've written something here. Those that have his mercy, those that have a relationship with him. Apostle, prophets, teachers, miracles, healings, helps. See, this is where the toilet bit comes in. Okay? There's also ministry in help. Hallelujah. In whatever you do, maybe help the poor. Maybe giving to them. Hallelujah. Those are the ministry. Because God cannot come down to give to the poor. The Israelites, usually when they harvest, he said to them, don't touch the edges. Leave it there. Because the poor will come and they'll pick from the edges. See, that's how God is using people. He doesn't come down to give to the poor. He uses you as his assistant to provide for the poor. Hallelujah. So even when you help, you are assisting God, helping others. In the governance of the church, you are also assisting him. A life that we might want to see is like Joseph. When you submit to assistant like Joseph, you will find grace in the sight of God, and you will have dominion over your situation. The Lord is with Joseph. If we read Genesis chapter 39 verse 2, it says, and the Lord was with Joseph, and he was a prosperous man, and he was in the house of his master, the Egyptian. So, you see, Joseph's life is a testimony. Now we're getting into the core of these things. Hallelujah. So many times people do not have to hear you. Hallelujah. So that's why I wrote there, Joseph's life was a testimony. Many times people do not have to hear you to be convinced. They see you and what you do and are convicted. You see? You do not have to talk all the time for people to be convinced. No, people can be convicted by the manner in which you do things. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians 4:2, the second part. He says, and by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. In the manifestation of the truth that commends us to the conscience of man. So people are going to see in your life truth. And when you do that, they are convicted in their conscience. It's amazing because there's a word this conscience said. But before that, let's go to Genesis chapter 39 verse 3. And his master saw that the Lord was with him. See? He just saw him. He didn't have to speak to him. And that the Lord made all that he did to prosper in his hand. This is what the master is saying, Joseph. He said, man, he saw the Lord was with him. How does he know that? Because he made all that he did to prosper in his land. So everything Joseph does was gold. Prospered. Why? Because the Lord was with him. That's the perception of the master. He said, and Joseph found grace in his sight, and he served him, and he made him overseer over his house. So when people see what God is doing in your life, they will honor God. Very, very simple. Hallelujah. And third, in the meaning of Sarat, we know it's a religious service to the Lord. Exodus chapter 28 verse 35, and it shall be upon Aaron to minister, here, Sarat, and his sound shall be heard when he goeth in unto the holy place before the Lord, and when he cometh out, that he die not. So our service is unto the Lord here. So now we see that according to Paul's letter to the Corinthians, if we can go back there, ministry comes after one finds mercy. So in other words, your relationship with your Heavenly Father is important. So what is really Paul talking about? He's speaking of the longevity, hallelujah, of the ministry and not giving up. So he's talking about not giving up and how your ministry can stay long and be fresh all the time. Hallelujah. So in other words, ministry should be preceded by one, to maintain the relationship with God, to maintain a relationship with family, neighbor, and in that order. And then your ministry comes after that. Okay. There's an important commandment where Paul based all this from, or our message is based from. It's in 1 John chapter 4, verse 20. And said, if a man say, I love God and hate his brother, he is a liar. For he that loved not his brother whom he hath seen, how can he love God whom he hath not seen? According to the scriptures, love your God and love your neighbor. Hallelujah. In the next one said, we find in Matthew chapter 22, verses 37 to 39, he said, Jesus said unto him, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, number one. And then this is the first in the great commandment. And then the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. So when these two are solid in your life, your ministry will thrive, and people cannot help but acknowledge. So it's right here, Yeshua is saying, love your God, and then love your neighbor. So your relationship with God in your ministry, no matter how menial it may have been. Hallelujah. But that's important to God. Why? Because he cannot come down. And he is using you. And he is using me to be their assistant. To be his assistant in fulfilling his plan on this earth. And that's very important for us to understand. So when these two are solid, your relationship with God and your relationship with neighbor, and people cannot help but notice. Cannot help but notice. So some of the questions that we might ask. Why do ministry, what make people give up ministry? Hallelujah. So they lose their first love. Revelation 2:4, nevertheless I have somewhat against thee, because thou hast left thy first love. So relationship with God must be strong. Hallelujah. What another thing that make people give up? 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 2. But have renounced the hidden things of dishonesty, not walking in craftiness, nor handling the word of God deceitfully, but by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in God. So in our text today, we find this is one of the things, because we still harbor feelings. I say that again. We still harbor things in our life, the hidden things in our life. Hallelujah. Paul is saying to the Corinthians, this we should renounce. Hallelujah. This is why people give up. People in high places, people in the high office, they fall and their ministry is terminated because they don't deal with things that are hidden. And Paul is saying here, one of the reasons that people give up is because they don't deal with the hidden things. Hallelujah. So, hidden things of dishonesty. Okay, so the hidden things of dishonesty is translated from the word boset. Now that changes the whole meaning. So when you speak of dishonesty, it's a bit hard to explain. So meaning shame and confusion. Sometimes it is hard to speak of dishonesty. However, dishonesty is the result of not renouncing the shameful things we cannot talk about. So you are not hurting others, but you are hurting and not being truthful and dishonest with yourself. So when the Bible speaks, when Paul is speaking here of dishonesty, it's a byproduct. So because the word boset, where dishonesty comes here, means shame and confusion. So a lot of people cannot speak of things because they are ashamed. There may be things that happened in their lives when they were young, but they are ashamed to bring it out. Hallelujah. And brings confusion in their life. Did Yeshua forgive this? Yes, He has forgiven. He has forgiven. You are now, even with that thing still hidden there, you have eternal life, because the Bible said it's through your confession that He is the Son of God and believing in your heart that He was raised on the third day. That brought you eternal life. But you see occasions in church where people are suffering because of the hidden things not renounced. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They still live with that shame. So your ministry can be affected because of the things that you don't want to talk about. Hallelujah. Shameful things that are there. So sometimes it is hard to speak. However, dishonesty is a result of not renouncing the shameful things we cannot talk about. So when you don't renounce this thing, you are being dishonest with yourself. Don't worry about others, but you are dishonest to yourself. You're not helping yourself at all. And another word there, it says not walking in craftiness. Now, the Hebrew word is rimya. Rimya comes from the Hebrew word rum, meaning to exalt self, and second is ya. So rimya means to exalt self above God. There you go. That's pride. That's pride. I said from the outset, we must remember that our relationship needs to be first. Hallelujah. Our relationship needs to be first. Because otherwise, you have this rimya. You have this exalting yourself above God. Means to exalt. So people start to notice your ministry and pride start to manifest. Remember, it is God's plan. You are only the assistant. Okay, so what is happening? It's only God's plan. You are the assistant. So you must remember again, your ministry comes first. Your relationship needs to be first. Otherwise, rimya will come. You will exalt yourself. That's what happened to Satan. Lucifer exalted himself above God. And rest is history. You don't want that to happen to you. You want your ministry to have that longevity. And through your ministry, however menial it may be, you can be excited and be satisfied with the fact that you are assisting God. You're not assisting the pastor. You are assisting God. in maintaining what he plans for us. Hallelujah. So it's very important. Men's conscience. And it's very important for us to see that. But by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience. I love this word. The Hebrew word that's used here in the sight of God. So this word comes from the Hebrew word matzipun. Matzipun comes from the root word safan, meaning to hide by covering over, to hold, to protect. People will want to say, let me explain this thing. Okay? I love this word. The reason why I love this word is because it's exciting. Hallelujah. It says here, so that every man's conscience, we're commending ourselves to every man's conscience. So, like Joseph, you just see, the master just see him. So people just see you do your work. Go about your business. All in truthfulness. You know what happened? Sefud. And the meaning of the word is to hide, to covering over, to hoard. You know what hoard is? You want everything for you. But people will want you. They want to hide you. They want you for themselves. Hallelujah. That's what it meant here, because they are so convicted by the way you administer your ministry through truth and through love. And they want to own you. That's the word. They don't want to share you with somebody else. Hallelujah. So it's important. Hallelujah. I was going to one of the churches lately to help them with their sound, and of course they don't have their musicians there. So somehow some other churches heard about it, and they were saying, "Wow, they're going to use him. They're going to use him." And the person that told me this conversation actually added that, "Wow, they don't want to share you." So, in other words, she noticed that the comment by that person from the other church, he's saying, "Wow, but I sometimes go to that church." Hallelujah. What I'm trying to say to you is when the people see what you do, they will start to want you just for themselves. You might call it selfish, maybe, but that's how it works, because that's what Paul is saying here. So by manifestation of truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God, you become to them theirs. Hallelujah. So today, it's a short message, and in summary, I just want to share this with you. I want to take this time to officially declare the year 2006 for Central Messianic One New Man, Sydney and Fiji, the year of serving. Serving in the ministry. So, Central Messianic want to see a lot of assistance this year. In whatever you're already doing, you must understand, God appreciates it. Because you have availed yourself to that. And 2016 is going to be an increase. Hallelujah. And everybody that is listening, for those of you in Lotoka and here in Sydney, hallelujah, there is going to be an increase in our ministry. That's talking about individual menial job, the little things that we do. You know, every big thing starts from little things. The Bible said that things that you see now, that now you can see, start from things that are not seen. So, in the atomic level, into the microscopic level, everything that you see here, they start from there. Something that's not seen. Hallelujah. Very small. So, however menial is what you do, you must remember you are in a system to the Almighty God. Hallelujah. So, ministry as we understand today is how you become God's assistant, fulfilling what is physically impossible for him to do. You become his hand, you become his feet, and you become his mouth. So let's have a look at that summary again. Hallelujah. So ministry, as we understand today, is how you become God's assistant, fulfilling what is physically impossible for God. That's the word I'm looking for. Hallelujah. He cannot physically come to do it. So you become his hand, you become his feet, and you become his mouthpiece. And for mouthpiece, I want to close with this word. Hallelujah. It's in Jeremiah chapter 15, verse 19. Hallelujah. Jeremiah chapter 15, verse 19. Therefore, thus saith the Lord, if thou return, hallelujah, then will I bring thee again, and thou shalt stand before me. And if thou take forth the precious from the vial, thou shalt be as my mouth. Let them return unto thee, but return not unto them. The precious from the vial. Hallelujah. It's very important for us to understand that. The precious from the vial. Hallelujah. So, we are the mouthpiece. Therefore, thus saith the Lord. Hallelujah. So, in summary, in whatever capacity you are assisting the Almighty God, do it with diligence, completely delivered from hidden shame. When people see you become their hidden treasure, committed to their conscience, because you represent the true meaning of ministry. And in conclusion today, Ecclesiastes. In conclusion today, Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 10. Whatsoever thy hand findeth to do, do it with thy might. For there is no work, nor device, nor knowledge, nor wisdom in the grave where thou goest. Hallelujah. And this morning, I said to you that that's where we go. So now, whatever we find our hand to do, do it with diligence. Understand that you are in a system to him. Hallelujah. Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom. Let's take this time. We're going to go across to Lotoka. If we can just get the change the screen there. Hallelujah. While I get Emmanuel. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Shalom. Can you hear me? Shalom. Can you hear me? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes, Pastor Ray.
All right. Okay.
You can hear me?
Yep.
Okay. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, we thank you. For your love. Thank you for the blood of Yeshua. This morning, we are grateful that you can rely on us to assist you. And we know it all began at Calvary. And we are thankful for the body. Thank you for the cup. Blood of the new covenant. And this morning, we respect, O Father, all the work. And we are thankful that we are here in your rest. We're committing ourselves in your rest. We receive our healing. We are here to take our healing. We receive our prosperity, and we are here to take that prosperity. Because it's all been promised. It's all ready for us. And Father, this morning we give you praise. We give you honor in Yeshua's mighty name we pray, and everybody say with me, Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We just pray for, we just thank everyone for their giving. And it's time for our tithe and offering. Remember, in whatever you do it for the Lord. I know that word's been thrown away, like, you know, today you're understanding it in a new way. Hallelujah. So I'm just going to pray for you. Father, I speak blessing, and I speak, Father, the release of your word connected to giving this morning. We now understand that we've given in your place. We've given because you want us to assist you in that department, in that area. And Father, we thank you that you are a God that with your righteousness you pay us. Or you reimburse us, O Lord. And Father, we thank you for the truth of your word in its application, for the giving that your children are doing for Central Messianic. And Father, we thank you for those that are doing their giving electronically, people that are giving through internet banking, O Lord. Father, we just thank you for their lives. An increase in their understanding, an increase in their prosperity. For the year 2016, O Lord, they're going to see a manifestation, hallelujah, of the goodness of who you are. And Father, we thank you. And as we are about to finish our broadcast, as we're about to finish our service, Lord, we commit to you our lives for the 2016, O Lord. Every man, every woman, and every child that is listening, and those that are not listening, members of our congregation, we commit their lives to you in the year 2016. Father, that you will go before them, that you be behind them, that you will surround them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And for this, Father, we ask you and we thank you for the prayer of the blessing, O Lord. Hallelujah. And now, Father, we just thank you that you are going to speak to us the blessing in Hebrew. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We ask Emmanuel to give us the blessings in Hebrew. Shalom. 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 Hallelujah. Once again, I want to thank everybody for watching this morning. It's a great day today. When we couldn't get the people in the facility we use, Noella started organizing all this. The boys were setting it up. And I just want to thank the Witt family for allowing us to have their service here. And for all of you that are watching through stream, I haven't got the list, but wherever you are, you are welcome, and we thank you for just being part of the service. And I just pray that 2016 is going to be the year of ministry, the year of service, the year of service for Central Messianic. And I hope for you, any member of other congregation that's there, you're going to put this in your heart, that in your own way, you have a ministry, that you are assisting God himself in your church, wherever church you go to. Hallelujah. And the Lord bless you. And Shabbat Shalom and Shavuot Tov, everyone. Thank you. Hallelujah.